Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Mumtaz Muhammad Faisal, ministry number 1182049. Today, we're going to be evaluating Damansara Holding Berhad based on the Kinsey criteria. A little bit about Damansara Holding Berhad. Damansara Company is a public company that specialises in the penny stock and the property sector. It has three major business segments that involve development, management and consultation services. Now, let's evaluate Damansara Company based on Kinsey criteria. So the first criteria is current earnings. So generally, investors look for EPS growth that over 20%. The higher the EPS, the more profit generated from the industry averages. However, for Damansara Company, the quarterly report shows that a drop of 38% indicates that the company generates lesser profit compared to the previous report. Second criteria, annual earnings. So according to William J. O'Neill, an ideal company must have over 25% of annual EPS growth for the past 5 years and ROE over 17%. In the case of Damansara Company Berhad, the growth only sustained for the past 3 years, except for the 2020 and 2021. Third is news. So news here could be change in management or new trend in the industry. So news are crucial for investors because it causes a short-term excitement which increases the stock price. However, not all news are relevant. In the case of Damansara Company, the top 3 news doesn't have much impact to the company share value. Next is supply and demand. In theory, strong demand from investor could push the stock price up. The stock value raise when the daily volume traded is higher compared to the average volume traded. Unfortunately, for Damansara Company, the daily volume traded is lesser compared to the average volume traded. So, Damansara score 0 point. Criteria number 5, leader or laggard. To know whether a company is leader or laggard, the relative price strength is used to determine a company's position in a specific industry. From the scale of 1 to 99, the top score company usually score between 80 and above. Based on the graph, Damansara Company is considered as a leader company because the price is higher compared to the DPS resources per head. Criteria number 6, institutional investors. In Malaysia, we have many institutional investors such as Khazanah Nasional Berhad and Lembaga Tabung Haji. This company is what we call sharp. So with the presence of sharp, usually a company's stock price will grow higher since this company have more resources to invest in the market. Unfortunately, for Damansara Holding Berhad, there is no big institutional to find the company. The final criteria is market direction. So market direction falls under technical analysis category. The strategy suggests to make new purchases only when market is in uptrend and take a depreciation when the market show a weak signal. From the graph, we can see that Damansara Company have a possibility to go uptrend in the short term period if they manage to break through the resistance. In conclusion, Damansara Holdings Berhad managed to score 2 out of 7 using Kinsey strategy with a weighted average of 20 out of 100. Therefore, it is advisable for investor to avoid purchase this Damansara stock to avoid further losses in the future. That's all from me. Thank you.